Here's your host, Alex Garrett.
Well, as we hit the first Sunday in December, that is the first Sunday in Advent, and, you know, it's Sling TV Sunday, but I wanted to get a little bit faith-based today because it is the first Sunday in Advent, and I always make a point in the last 9 years to make sure this day is highlighted because when we hit the Advent season, it's supposed to be a time of rejoicing, of renewal, of excitement that Christ is born. But when you see the headlines, it doesn't always feel like that. So that's why we have to really grab on to God this holiday Christmas season. Because I think that is paramount to celebrate Advent, to honor his birth. Because as marred as this Christmas season has felt with the protesting at the Rockefeller Christmas tree, with the ongoing worries of the Jewish Americans, of their family and loved ones in Israel, to, yes, even Jamaica, Queens, where there was an awful stabbing yesterday, last night, killing a whole family of four, awful, and slashing of cops. This is the time where we have to lean on God a lot more and be one with him, if you will, this Christmas season. And how do we do that? Well, I wanted to do this. By the way, Sling TV, you can catch some different games today, obviously, in another NFL week. But here are 10 passages, which I wanted to highlight for you, through Crosswalk for Advent season. And you can turn to these as well. Number one, according to Crosswalk.com, from Isaiah 9:6. For us, a child is born, to us, a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. The Spirit of the Lord, the Sovereign Lord, is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives, and release from darkness for the prisoners. Now, you mentioned the poor. Obviously, Giving Tuesday was just one day, but all Christmas long, I know you'll be giving and you'll be supporting local food pantries and local food drives and coat drives and the like. And God bless you for that as well. Fulfillment. Let's go to Luke 4:18. The Spirit of the Lord is on me because he has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free. And we're going to talk about this with Mario Gallucci in his next Mr. Acquittal podcast, so stay tuned for that. Let's go to Isaiah 7:14. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel. Matthew 1:23 says, the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. You can go through all of these different passages Crosswalk recommends for the Christmas season. And on Bethlehem, in Micah 5:2, the Lord says, Bethlehem, you might not be an important town in the nation of Judah, but out of you will come a ruler over Israel for me. His family line goes back to the early years of your nation. It goes all the way back to days of long ago. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem. So take a look at all these different passages, and maybe, just maybe, in this time of hardship, in this time of worry, in this time of even darkness for you, these passages can give you hope that, yes, celebrating Christ's birth amidst all this turmoil and chaos is what we need as we hit the season of Advent in 2023. I've said for a while now, it's going to be a very different Advent season. It's going to be a different Christmas season because no one feels happy right now. No one seems happy. Everyone seems stressed out and frustrated. And yes, inflation doesn't help with that. These wars aren't helping with anything. And for some, the leader of the free world is not helping either. And that's why we have to go above all of that and say, you are with us, God. We know that. And we will read these passages to help us remember that and honor that this Advent season 2023. God bless you on Sling TV Sunday. And may you be blessed. And may you be fulfilled by these passages I put in the description below from Crosswalk. And I just pray you have hope and some Christmas spirit as we honor Emmanuel's birth later this month on December 25th. And I know Hanukkah will feel very different and feel very pensive. But maybe those 8 days of light can bring us hope as well. For if that faith and that light can last 8 days, one singular light, maybe our faith can last an eternity. That God knows what is going on, and He is helping us day by day by day. So to kick off Advent, may you be filled with His light after a week of tree lightings here in New York. Talk to you soon.